starting to feel bad for Mrs. Stevenson.
Thank you.
Erica's right. This sounds like more than just your average prank call. These guys are plotting a murder.
I know. You'd think they'd check to make sure they had a secure connection first.
Amateurs. I mean, part of what makes it creepy is all the details they give. Like, only one light visible from the street. At 11:15, a subway train crosses the bridge.
Why are those details creepy?
Just makes it feel more real.
At the same time, the information doesn't come out all at once. We're listening to a plan, but we don't know what it's for.
Until we do.
Right, until we get to the line, make it quick, as little blood as possible. Our client does not wish to make her suffer long.
We're losing Erica.
I'm sorry. I get scared if I'm alone in a house at night. Even if I'm not alone, I can still get kind of nervous. Does that sound lame?
Yeah.
No way. Everyone's scared of something.
My point is, I can relate to the way Mrs. Stevenson is feeling. She's trying to reach her husband because she wants to feel better. But what she hears instead is straight out of a nightmare.
I gotta say, one of the scarier parts of the scene is when they can't hear her.
Yeah, I noticed that too.
To me, that does feel like a nightmare. When you're trying to speak and no one can hear you.
That's the worst.
And the title is kind of like that too.
What do you mean?
Sorry, wrong number? It's so cold. Have you ever seen someone lose it when they're talking to an automated system?
Like my dad on the phone with the internet company?
Yeah.
There's something about needing a response and not getting it that can drive someone crazy.
Totally.
So, unless this is a really complicated prank, it sounds like Miss Stevenson's nightmare is coming true.
I guess the question is, does the fact that she's nervous and high maintenance add to the tension, or make the story less intense?
You know, yes, Mrs. Stevenson annoys me, I'm not gonna lie about that. But as far as the dramatic tension goes, if she were just a little bit more chill, I don't think that phone call would be so scary.
Right. I mean, her health is poor, she's popping pills. This woman is on the edge of a panic attack.
If she doesn't get killed first.
So you think these guys are planning on killing her?
Don't you?
Well, yeah, but I was hoping I was wrong.
We'll have to finish reading to see.
So now I am curious, Daniela. What scares you?
I'll never tell.
Oh, come on, you have to be afraid of something.
Secret.